Good afternoon, one and all. Today we discuss the topic theoretical approaches to sociology of education in our course sociology of education. Today's lecture outline, introduction, why we study the sociology of education, overviews on sociology of education, what is the necessity to study the sociological theories, who are the proponents of sociological theories, what is meant by theoretical perspective, what are the major paradigms of sociological theories, conflict theory, key takeaways, points for reflection, and the objective of the session. When you are go through this session, you will be able to understand the need to study the sociology of education. You will be able to understand the need to study the sociological theories. You will be able to know the proponents of sociological theories. You will be able to understand the major sociological perspectives. You will be able to understand the conflict theory. Learning outcomes. At the end of the session, you will be able to explain the sociological theory. You will be applying the sociological theory in your workplace. You will be able to explain the contribution of conflict theories towards education. What is meant by sociology? What is meant by education? How sociology and education come together? And how this sociology of education is helpful to study the society and the human being? The dictionary meaning of sociology is the systematic study of society and social interaction. The word sociology is derived from the Latin word socius, means companion, and the Greek word logos means the speech or reason, which come together mean the reason, speech or discourse about companionship. The sociologist Dorothy Smith in 1926 defined the social as the ongoing concerting and coordinating of individuals' activities. Sociology is the systematic study of all those aspects of life designated by the adjective social. One of the important definitions I want to discuss it, according to the layman, layman is the sociologist, according to the layman, sociology is the study of man's interaction within the society, but it extends beyond that as it deals with the organization and the control of man's behaviors and attitudes within the society. Now, though, what is education? The word education, it is originated from the Latin word educere, means to draw out or to lead out. This shows that man is endowed with some basic qualities or potentials which are embedded to him. Education can further be explained as the nourishment of an individual to attain natural capacity in life. This could be done through the training and upbringing of such individuals in the traditional and modern ways to become acceptable members of the society in which they live. Or we, in why we study the sociology of education. Sociology, there are the reasons why we study the sociology of education. Or the sociology can be existing because why we study? Because it teaches people ways to recognize how they fit into the world and how others perceive them. Looking at themselves and society from a sociological perspective helps people to see where they connect to different groups based on many different ways they classify themselves and how society classifies them in turn. It raises awareness of how those classifications, such as economic level, status level, education level, ethnicity, or sexual orientation, affect the perceptions. Sociology teaches people not to accept the easy explanation. Easy explanation means they think and give the explanation. So it teaches them a way to organize their thinking so that they can ask better questions and formulate the better answers. It makes people more aware that there are many different kinds of people in the world who do not necessarily think the way they do. It increases their willingness and the ability to try to see the world from other people's social and the educational perspectives. This prepares them to live and work in increasingly diverse and integrated world. Overview of sociology of education. The sociology of education is a branch of general sociology. Auguste Comte is the father of sociology. R.C. Engel, Durkheim, Lesterwart, Brookover, Goethe are the major contributors of sociology of education. According to the Engel, researches developed in school situation is nothing but the sociology of education. Sociology of education is a scientific analysis of social process and social pattern involved in the educational system. Development of the scientific generalization about human relations in educational system. Education process goes on both formal and informal situation. That's why the sociology of education is the study of how public institution and individual experiences affect education and its outcomes. Sociology of education. The objective or the aim of the sociology of education are to analyze the human relations and society, to study the social role of teacher, determination of various teaching methods for the socialization of child, study of whole society and the other aspect of the sociology, society towards education. The sociology of education is the study of how the social, how public institutions and individual experiences affect education and its outcomes. How social institutions and forces affect educational process and its outcomes and vice versa. Sociology of education emphasizes the sociological problems in the realm of education, which is concern of sociologists. It also emphasizes the analysis of sociological process involved in the educational institution. The sociology of education introduces the teacher to understand the sociological perspective of education, which include learner, teacher, and the educational institution. Sociology of education enables the teacher to understand the importance of interaction with the learners to various sociological problems which is related to the education. Sociology of education helps the teacher to understand the community of educational institution as well as the part of larger society. Sociology of education helps the teacher to understand the social purpose of education from the societal perspective. Sociology of education prepares the teacher to be a trained agent of the society. Why we study the sociological theories? Sociological theories means it's a set of statements that explain problems, actions, and the behaviors. There are the three reasons to study the sociological theories: research and policy formulation, logical explanation, and relation between two or more concepts. The theories guides research and policy formulation in the sociology of education. Theory also provides the logical explanation for why things are happening the way they do. A theory is a proposed relationship between two or more concepts. An effective theory may have an explanatory and predictive power. Theories help sociologists to understand the educational system, and it's also contribute to our understanding of education as a part of society. Then proponents of the sociological theories. The proponents of sociological theories are Karl Marx, Charles Parsons, George Herbert Mead, Emil Durkheim, Max Weber, Robert Merton, Herbert Blumer, Louis Althusser, and Ralph Darden. They are more contributed to sociological theories into the sociology of education. Then let's come to the theoretical perspectives. What is meant by theoretical perspectives? Sociologists study social events, interactions, and patterns, and then they develop theories to explain why these occur and what can result from them. Sociological theories means, we already discussed it, is a set of statements that seeks to explain problem, action, and behavior. A theory is a proposed relationship between two or more concepts. An effective theory may have explanatory and predictive power. Theories are always of organizing and explaining the world in which we live. Theories change over time and the space. In shortly, we can say, in sociology, a theory is a way to explain different aspects of social interactions and to create testable proposition about the society. Let's take one of the example. Here the Durkheim propositions that differences in suicide rate can be explained by differences in the degree of social integration in different communities is a theory. How he developed this theory? I will explain how he developed this theory. Now, the Durkheim gathered data on large group of people in Europe who had ended their lives. When he analyzed the data, he found that suicide rate differed among the groups with different religious affiliations. The data showed that Protestants were more likely to commit suicide than the Catholics. There are the two groups in Europe at that time. It is the Protestants and the Catholics. To explain these, Durkheim developed the concept of social solidarity. And he described what is social solidarity? The social ties that bind a group of people together, such as kinship, shared locations, or religions. Durkin combined these concepts with the data he analyzed to propose a theory that explained the religion-based differences in society rates. He suggested that differences in social solidarity between the two groups corresponds to the difference in society rates. So this is how he developed this theory. In sociology, a few theories provide broad perspectives that help to explain many different aspects of social life. Sociology is a multi-perspective science. A number of distinct perspectives or paradigms offer competing explanation of the social phenomena. Paradigms means the paradigms are the philosophical and the theoretical frameworks used within a discipline to formulate theories, generalization, and the experiments or the research performed in support of. There are the three major paradigms have come to dominate the sociological thinking because they provide useful explanation. So what are the major paradigms or the sociological perspective? The conflict theory, or we can first the structural functionalism, conflict theory, structural functionalism, and the symbolic interaction. So these are the three major paradigms. Now, what are these paradigms and their analysis? We are studying in detail in upcoming lectures, but just for your knowledge, functionalism, what is functionalism? Is different sociological perspectives enable sociologists to view social issues through a variety of useful lenses. The paradigms. Let's take functionalism. And what is the analysis of this functionalism? How each part of the society functions together to contribute to the whole. Then conflict theory, how inequalities contribute to social differences and perpetuate differences in power. Then symbolic interaction means its analysis is one-to-one interaction and the communications. Now let's take the conflict theory. Conflict theory by Karl Marx. Karl Marx is a founder of communism and the theory conflict theory. This is the background of Karl Marx. He is born in Germany. He began attending sociologist meeting in Germany. He wrote the Communist Manifesto with the Friedrich Engels. Though ignored in his life, his ideas gained rapid acceptance after his death in 1883. What about the conflict theory? As per the Karl Marx. So these are the points to explain the conflict theory. Number one, conflict divide society divided into two classes. Struggle between the social classes, causes of conflict, mode of conflict, and the role of education. Now, what is the conflict theory? Conflict theories are the theories of social transmission. It emphasizes a person's or group ability to exercise influence and control over them. Conflict theory has the roots in ideas of Karl Marx. Conflict theory emphasizes the dominance of some societal groups. Social order as based on manipulation and control by the dominant group. Social change is occurring rapidly in disorderly fashion as subordinate group overthrow as dominant group. As per the Karl Marx, in all society there are the two major social groups, the ruling class or the subject class or the dominant class, right? It examines conflict of interest that hold society. Disagreement or the clash between opposing sides, principles or the peoples. It can be over to convert a conflict. It forces on heterogeneous nature of society and unequal distribution of political and social power. Means these are the two classes. It is the class of capitalists, that is the ruling class, and class of wage laborers, that is the working class or the subject class. Now, according to the Karl Marx, he said that the economics forms basis of human activities, which is determined who had the power in society. Believe working class was oppressed by the ruling class. Means there is a struggle. Conflict theory focuses the unequal distribution of political and social power in struggle between the social classes. So, as per the Marxist dialectical method, existing social agreement, which is known as the thesis, it generates its social opposites, that is the antithesis, and a different social form in synthesis emerges from the struggle between the two classes. The basis of the conflict, why the conflict is happening? Because of class, economical class or the status, socioeconomic status, the race and the ethnicity, gender, male and female, then regions and the various religions. The country like India, there are the various regions and the religions. And we studied a lot of conflicts on the basis of religion, regions, gender, race, ethnicity, and the classes, socioeconomic status, low socioeconomic status, high socioeconomic status, powerful society, unpowerful society. So these are the basis of the conflict. There are the various modes of conflicts. How we get the justice? So what are that? Welfare and revolutions, various strikes and the dominations. So these are the mode of conflicts. The impact of conflict theory on education. How schools contribute to the unequal distribution of people into the jobs in society. More powerful members of society maintain the best positions and less powerful groups are allocated to the lower rank. Role of education in conflict theory plays an important role. It plays a big part maintaining the prestigious power and economic and social position of the dominant group in the society. A conflict theory assumes that social behavior is best understood in terms of conflict or tensions between opposing the groups. Conflict theory deals with the incompatible aspects of society and how they clash with one another. Interested in how social institutions like education, economy, family, media helps to maintain the overwhelming of small group. Emphasis in social change and the redistribution of the resources makes conflict theories more radical and activist in the functionalist. The limitations of the conflict theory. The conflict theory overlooks the stability of the societies. It focuses on change and the conflict. There are the, we already studied the various modes of conflict, basis of the conflict, and how to overcome the modes. For the change, that's why it focuses on change and the conflict. It stresses on the power struggle. So these are the limitations of the conflict theory. So session review or the conclusion of this session. Sociology is the systematic study of society and social interaction. Sociologists develop theories to explain social events, interactions, and the patterns. Theories have different scales, micro-level theories such as structural functionalism and conflict theory, attempt to explain how societies operate as a whole. Micro-level theories such as symbolic interactionism focus on interactions between the individuals. Studying sociology is beneficial both for the individual and for society. By studying sociology, people learn how to think critically about the social issues and the problems that confront our society. Theory is a way to explain different aspects of social interactions and to create testable prepositions about the society. Conflict theory has roots in the ideas of Karl Marx. Conflict theory is a way to study the society that focuses on the inequalities of different groups in society. Karl Marx never says conflict is a good or bad, but it is an unavoidable aspect of the human nature. Class, race, ethnicity, gender, region, and religions are the causes of conflict. Welfare, revolution, strikes, and the dominations are the modes of conflicts. The points for reflection. Institutions should organize researchers meet on the various aspects of social education. Institutions should organize various seminars, conferences on sociological perspectives. And these are the references which I have referred. Hope you will enjoy the session. Thank you very much.